Welcome to episode 45, the missing episode of bullshit.
Welkom bij episode minus 1. Welkom bij episode 3
of Behind the Scenes with a host,
Ilo.
En Dragosz, de actor.
De director en de actor.
Without our meatbags. And we mean other respectful actors.
This episode, we're gonna have it about the two other ships we use in the movie and what we did to make them.
In this episode, we're looking at two ships we used in the episode one, the original one, which is on the right side, the white blue one, and the modified version, the black one, we use as the pirate ship. You can spot right away we need to gun it in order to attack the ship and paint it a little bit more badass than civilian white with blue.
Yeah, the original version of the ship was in the earlier stages of the game. Still has overlapping engines to make it in the ship it now is.
Because else everything explodes in the engine bay. And now we have a functional ship again.
And I needed to pipe it all up again. So let's take a look then.
So this ship named the Crystal was the first ship I put on the Steam Workshop. The name was because of a little bit of the color and the shape. I had a little bit experimental on the ship because my first ships always looked like floating concrete blocks. So I tried different things here. There's also a ship that I built in the very early stages of the game. So we have overlapping engines, which will destroy half of the ship by this time. We also have the basic weapon systems. Nothing is piped up. We also have the basic colors. And then you see we have a lot of engines at the sides, at the back, underneath and above. We also have hidden engines in the ship, which was a lot of trouble to get them out. We have our antennas and the beacon. And this ship is also pretty much to sea for my likings. Yeah, I put in a lot of work to make the new ship in it. So here at the back we have our landing bay. It's all light armor because heavy air armor didn't exist back then. There's a lot of lighting in it. And here we go to the what used to be stairs but are now walkways. Let's go up. And now let's go up again. And here we have our small incoming room, and then here we have our storage rooms with big storage crates, small storage crates and small reactors. And behind that wall we have another set of gyroscopes, which you can now not see. Here we have our main engine room. We have four of them in a row. So much lighting, a little bit defense. And here we go to the stairs to the upper floor. So on this top part we have the sleeping quarters. Here we have our protected windows, which will protect us from bullets, because we didn't have the glass back then. Here we have Dragosz, and here we have our medic bay, very simple design, nothing too fancy, and here we have our cabin. Yeah, some kind of sleeping beds, improvised, and some storage crates, because this ship was used a little bit as a ferry ship I had in mind, so we don't need too much luxury. And then you can see here we also have a little bit too much space, which we can use better. So much defense. And here we have the original part, which I built first. The other part I built later. Here we have one big block and then some other blocks around it. And gyroscopes. And here we have our cockpit. Which is a nice view. Standard cockpit. Now let's fly the ship. Oh, no, not the ship. So you see that the ship is 3.3 million kilos, so it isn't that bad. We don't have much power left. We have a decent acceleration. And oh, now we're hitting something. That isn't very good of me. The ship can also take a little bit of beating, because it is a little bit more of a passenger ship than a warship, also because of the light armor.
We create a new entry point.
That's why we don't use light armor anymore.
Well, I use light armor very much. To make the ship lighter. And let's go see what I have changed on the ship. The first thing you will notice, that thrust is there, and there no more. Because of all the clipping effects, so I removed all those. Still kept them on at the front. Get two more turrets added. I left punch this one because of all the piping that needs to be done. But I filled them up with other stuff. The exterior is pretty much the same overall. With now new windows over here. There. And I also extended those here. You can see there are only one of those. I extended this to two because of the lack of thrust. But for the most part it is still about the same ship. Exterior wise there's not much change. Now the interior. Here we still have our landing bay. With heavy armor this time.
And very heavily modified to the other fashion with conveyor pipes, connectors.
Much more cargo containers for the excess room we had. And there we see our. We go up here to the stairs. And of course, it is a pirate ship we have here, our prisons. So. Ransoming money, but proceed to keep the prisoners alive. First we go to the ship. So we have more space here. So we have here windows and such. And here we have our captain's quarters, which is by far the biggest there is, with a double bed. Or something like it, and with its own cockpit and meeting area. Big view. And then over here, we have mailed on the other side too. We have our first officer, or who the hell that might be. Here two cabins, and then here we have for the rest of the crew. And here we have our command center, so that the rest of the crew can get each their own separate gun for better aiming and such. Because you don't want to destroy everything as a pirate. Because you will lose value later to other cells. Just the same as below. And here we have our confusing mess of gyros, storage crates, other things, generators, and behind. Here and in the other pods we have even more storage crates. And then we have our bottom entrance. See all pipe up and such. Let's go here. Dragos always get lost in the ship. You see at the top we have, if I can get through. Here we have at the piston, we have a grinder getting an entrance. Connector and a collector. Connectors from the merge block. This will always come by in handy. Those here are also crammed with storage crates and such. Here are the top entrance. More storage crates. You have to do something with space. And behind that glass here, there was thrusters behind him, mostly. So I replaced him with glass and gyroscopes. There was a rocket launcher behind here. Here we have the cockpit, which is pretty much the same as over there.
Only with more fueling space.
So this ship is some 3 tons heavier than the ships.
And slower.
Well, it is fast in a ship. And somewhat more maneuverable. useful, and I chose this color scheme to go more blend in. It was mostly gray, black, standard gray.
Space background.
So it is pretty nice to see. Blends well. The surroundings. But that was the crystal and the kissy on the ship. Now we go to the other ship, our Rissar bus, which I created to ferry people around. Have some engines and have two connector blocks, which I first had on pistons, but then the ship will go crazy, so it will be dead. We have two multi blocks, and then on the light. And this ship was primarily used for ferrying people to stations and ships, or from ships to stations. It has some 13 seats, there's some standing seats, and some surrounding views. Here we have a crate, luggage. Now the front, like a big nice view, the driver has the control over the doors and such. And then we have a modified, this is what we use for recording somewhat. And this was the one we used in episode 1 of Behind the Scenes.
Yep.
This will circle around the station. And it has its own power supply for if we go in survival mode. So, and it works, I tweak the gyro so it keeps turning around. And then one thruster is slowly thrusting it about. And then about every 2 seconds, one thruster at the front keeps giving it a blast so it has the same speed all over. So it don't go 110 meters per second. And then I converted this ship to the Rissau, the armored assault craft. So this ship has, instead of the connector block and the merge blocks, it has 2 Gatling guns and a missile turret. There's also much more armor. Still it has more thrusters at the front. Size and 2 big blasters at the end instead of a few small ones. And on the inside, you will see, open up the door. Then you will see we have 1 and 2 for the guns, and also enough seating for the crew, for the boarding party. We have the cargo containers as well. Here the cockpit, you will see we have somewhat less viewing capabilities, but you are much more dependent. And it isn't that much bigger than the original one. And to be honest, it is somewhat nice. Also with the camel colors. And this is the vessel we use to escape in. Season 1, episode 1. The missing engine and the missing guns. Well, that concludes this episode of Behind the Scenes. I say to the next episode.
Goodbye!